Good morning, children. Yesterday we have done about the themes of literature. Now in the themes we got to know that what are they telling us about the themes in literature, that the relation of human with God, the relation of man with himself, the relation of man with society. This is what we have done yesterday. Now today we'll do a new topic, that is the classification of literature, how the literature got classified, okay, into which forms did it got classified. Basically we have got the three key points in which we learn about its classification. We get a fairly comprehensive scheme of classification, and one which, as will be seen, has the advantage of resting upon natural foundation. Now we have seen different type of schemes about the classification of literature, okay, and all of them are laid upon the natural foundations. Means nothing was artificial, everything was very natural, one after the other it got emergence, okay. Suppose again we'll go back to the Renaissance and Reformation period. We'll see that when the Renaissance movement got activated, there came a lot of Greek and ancient stories, or Greek and ancient work basically, which got translated. After the translation, we got various translators who started translating Greek and Latin language into English. As a result, then again there was a natural outgrowth of various writers who already knew English. They started writing their own stories, drama, novel, prose, epic, romance, everything, okay. Now as a result, when we saw that there came many writers one after the other, then there was a need of printing press, so that it will help in printing the work of the writers easily, and will produce the work in a bulk. As a result, it will get distributed across the globe and the literature will become famous. So now what is the first classification? First, the literature of self-expression. Now what is actually drama, poetry or novel or anything? What you read about literature is basically about self-expression. The writer, what he or she is thinking, is writing that. So the writer is expressing himself or herself through its work, which includes different kinds of lyrics, lyric poetry, okay. These are the kinds of poetry: lyric poetry, the poetry of meditation and argument, the elegy, essay, treatise, where these are written from the personal point of view. See, these are all written what you have thought personally in your mind, or what the writer has thought personally in their mind. This is the first classification. Now what is the second classification? The literature in which the writer, instead of going down to himself, goes out of himself into the world of external human life and activity, okay. Now see, the second point is basically a devastating change in the classification of literature. In the first point, what we have learned is that the writer is himself or herself expressing his own or her own thoughts in his work. Now in the second part, we'll see that the writer, instead of going down to himself, instead of what he's thinking himself, he will go out to the external world, okay, means to the outside world, which is more practical than natural, okay, in which he will have life and activity, maybe, see, which includes history. History, if you talk about Indian history, we have Ramayana, we have Mahabharata, okay, these are the two famous epics of Indian history. So that this is actually the reality. In order to write Ramayana and Mahabharata in English or in the form of literature, what we have to do, we have to study the book, and that is the story which the writer cannot make on himself or think about its own. He has to write what exactly has been written in the epics. Now biography, okay. Biography also, what is biography? When you write something about any famous people, okay, suppose you get an essay to write the biography about Mahatma Gandhi. So in order to attempt or in order to write the biography, we first need to know the person thoroughly. We see nowadays everything, these biographies are depicted through movies, okay. Suppose Milkha Singh, for example, his biography, what did the actor Farhan Akhtar do? He has depicted the life of Milkha Singh through a drama, through a movie, okay. Like this one is ballad. We have got long poems that are called ballads. And what is epic? In Indian epic, India, we have two epics, Ramayana and the Mahabharata are the oldest epic. The romance and verse and prose, okay. Now, when you are writing, you can write in verse also and in prose also, and that can be romantic also. And when you write a story also, that can also be a verse and prose, a novel and drama. You can write anything, okay. The drama, we have done so many dramas of William Shakespeare in the second year, okay. We have done a novel of Jane Austen's Pride and Prejudice. So these are fabricated stories, okay. So this has been written. So in thirdly, we have the literature of description. In this, the literature has been described not in itself or a large or important division, okay. It is not only described it in a larger way, but it has got a very important division also. Since description in literature is ordinarily associated with, for the most part, subordinated to, okay. Now the description, what literature describes, is generally associated with not only the subordinated part, but also subordinate part means what the parts of the literature has been given. It's not only associated with it, but it is also associated with the interest of self-expression or narrative. What the person is expressing in the story or in the drama or epic or poem, and the narrative also, what the narration is telling. But comprising in the book of travel, but if we compile everything, like if we compile the book of travel is the book of journey, but if we compile everything in a book of journey or travel, descriptive essay and poem, what we find is descriptive essays and some poems and fairly distinct minor forms of literary art. Okay, there are various forms of literary art and essay, poem, and these are fairly distinct, means everything has been divided into segregated groups. Thank you.